And next we'll look at an element for capturing paragraphs. That is for capturing single but usually multi-line text with unknown contents. So amongst the properties, probably this is the most important setting, is line count. So you specify how many lines are in your paragraph. Maybe it's between 6 and 10 lines long, or if it's like an address paragraph, maybe it's between 3 and 5 lines long. We also have alignment and indentation settings, spacing settings, line size settings, and we also have a stamp removal capability from within the paragraph. So if you are very precise in setting these different settings, such as minimum and maximum line height, you may reduce your chances of matching a given document's paragraph. So you just want to use these settings with some caution. The go-to setting here is minimum and maximum line count. And then often I'll do relations, and I'll look for a paragraph that's nearest to some other element. Next element that we'll look at is the object collection element. And it allows us to find objects of predefined types. So this will allow us to go out and find logos, find checkmark OMR boxes, etc. So you can specify a minimum and maximum height and width. The date element is fairly self-explanatory. It helps you find dates, and we have the ability to specify different date formats. You can supply multiple date formats and multiple languages. You need to have images of good quality because there can be a problem reading a date such as this. So if this zero is formed like a C, then the FlexiLayout Studio date element probably won't read this as a date. And if you have characters such as this, you might want to use a character string with a regular expression with different wildcards to describe a date such as this. So if your images are of good quality, this tool works very, very well. The phone element is designed to help you capture phone numbers just based on a phone numbers format. And you can make some different setting adjustments. And what I have found is that this can work very well in text-heavy documents. Every once in a while when I've got documents that have a lot of different numbers, sometimes I've seen those different numbers be recognized as phone numbers. So you're going to want to do a little bit of testing when you use this phone number element. A currency element is all about finding currency values. And you don't need to have a currency prefix in order for a currency value to be found. And you can make some setting adjustments here to be able to hone in on a currency value. No errors are allowed during currency name searches. The last simple element we'll speak about is a region element. And this element is much like a character string element, except there is no character string tab. And in fact, there is no tab whatsoever that describes what a region could do. By what criteria will it capture a rectangle? capture data within a rectangle. You don't set that criteria. So a region is actually a very powerful tool, and you set its search area by using relations. Left of this, right of that, above this keyword, below that keyword, and you formulate a rectangle. And by formulating that rectangle, it will always search in that area whether it finds data or not. And that can be very useful when you've got highly degraded images that the engines struggle with in terms of good OCR quality. And a character string element, if used in that scenario, may retrieve very partial or no results at all. And it may not even find that rectangle because it didn't find any readable data in that rectangle. Whereas a character string, a region element, by contrast, will always pass that rectangle onto FlexiCapture. And sometimes a human may be able to make out what exactly was found there. So there's actually quite a few uses for the region element. So now that we've discussed simple elements, we can now talk about elements that are classified as compound elements. And these are elements which contain other elements. You can convert compound elements into other types of compound elements. The first compound element we'll look at is the group element. And the group element essentially can act as a container for other elements. So you can logically group together elements that are all trying to achieve the same goal. Maybe we're looking for a customer ID number. So we may use two or three elements as keywords to locate the actual customer ID number. And you can place that all in a group. So that helps document your layout. It simplifies a user's navigation through the layout. It decreases the number of hypotheses. And there's also inheritance. So if I place items in this group, such as static text elements and character string elements, but I set certain relations at the group level, like above this and below that, then everything in that group will inherit those relations.